I'm Stephen Sachs, owner of Solutions to Results, a consulting firm that helps CPA practices and organizations in the areas of culture, communications, education, and training. Today, we're having a second in the series of interviews with Jack Shaw. Today's program covers blockchain implications for CPAs. Unless you're already familiar with blockchain technology, I highly recommend that you watch the first part in the series, Blockchain Basics for Businesses. You won't lose anything by watching the second webcast first, but if you go back to the earlier one, you'll be provided with a broader perspective of blockchain technology in business. Our guest today is the aforementioned Jack Shaw. He's an innovation and change management consultant who's been voted one of the world's top 25 speakers and one of the top 5 technology futurists. Jack has delivered over 1,000 keynote presentations across the US and in 26 countries. His expertise is in the area of the strategic impacts of leading edge technologies in such areas as 5G, the Internet of Things, and artificial intelligence. Welcome, Jack.
Well, thanks very much, Steve. It's certainly a pleasure to join you again. And I'm looking forward to some more of your very interesting questions.
So, Jack, let me ask you about basic counting processes. I understand that The Economist magazine described blockchain as the most important advance in business record keeping since the innovation of double entry bookkeeping in Florence, Italy, in over 500 years. But now you're telling me that blockchain may eventually even replace double entry bookkeeping, something with something new? What is this something new, and how might it work?
That's a good question, and you're right. There's a very good possibility. A lot of leading experts in the field think that we will be seeing the emergence of what has come to be referred to as triple entry bookkeeping. Now, let me take a second here and share a slide with you, show you what I'm talking about. Here we see your traditional double entry bookkeeping entries. If entity A, say business A, is purchasing a product or service from business B, then we see that business A is recognizing in its books an entry of $100 cash expense and $100 expense. While entry B is recognizing the receipt of $100 cash and recognizing $100 in revenue. We're all familiar with the processes around this. Now, the difference with blockchain is that when these transactions are reflected through blockchain technology, typically in the process of engaging a smart contract, then we have a third entry on the blockchain that ties back to both of the two businesses' entries. In this case, it represents the transmission of the payment from company A to company B, $100 credit to company A's account, $100 debit to company B's account. This third permanent immutable blockchain-based record can then immediately be used to verify the authenticity of the transaction in both of the two companies' internal accounting systems, the cash credit and expense in company A's system and the cash debit and revenue recognition in company B's system. So triple entry bookkeeping may very well be an important part of the future of accounting as companies evolve toward blockchain-based technology.
But before we look more closely at audit and tax implications, can you help me understand how blockchain may affect general advisory services for CPAs?
Absolutely. So let's take a look at a chart that lays out both in the relatively near to intermediate term, looking out, say, the next 2 to 5 years, as well as the longer term, as we look out to the second half of the 2020s, how things may evolve in terms of these. What we're just starting to see, and mostly among larger companies right now, are some transactions appearing. But over the next few years, we'll see more and more business being done or being reflected in blockchain-based transactions. As we look out 5 to 10 years, we'll see in many industries, again, especially among mid-sized and larger companies, an evolution toward most or all of their routine business transactions taking place on the blockchain. General ledgers will start including a column to indicate whether a particular transaction is eligible to be verified on the blockchain or has been verified. If it hasn't been completed yet, it would be eligible. Once completed, it can be verified via a blockchain-based entry. Again, as we look out longer term, what this means is that many transactions will begin to be shared with relevant authorized third parties like CPAs, but also perhaps appropriate regulatory agencies and so forth, who will then have access to information that they are authorized to access anyway, but in real time, have immediate real-time access to verified, authenticated key business transactions on the blockchain. Now, over the next few years, we're starting to see both regulatory agencies, whether they're taxing authorities, we'll come back to that later, or other kinds of regulatory agencies, but also technology solution providers offering ERP and accounting software systems, enabling their processes and their systems to reflect and take advantage of blockchain-based business transactions. So that as we move out to the 5 to 10 year period, we'll see where most individuals and organizations have many of their routine, if not all of their routine business transactions reflected in T accounts with triple entry bookkeeping, blockchain-based transactions, data on the blockchain, being able to verify the internal transactions in their accounts and also tie back to verify those of their trading partners. So everybody is in sync with all these legitimate business transactions, thoroughly vetted, verified, and visible to all those who are authorized to see them, although only those who are authorized to see them. Now, what does this mean looking forward for CPAs? Well, it means over the next few years, really starting now, but and continuing over the next 2 to 3 to 5 years, CPAs will have to not only prepare themselves, but also their clients to understand how blockchain is going to affect accounting issues. But also, they're going to have to understand and help their clients to understand how blockchain may impact underlying business models. Now, again, as you recall, Steve, in our program on blockchain basics for business, we talked about how blockchain could impact supply chains and eliminate the needs for things like invoices and automate payments through smart contracts. I'm not going to repeat that information, but the point is that there are any number of ways in which blockchain will be able to enable far faster, more efficient business models. So as we look down the road 5 to 10 years, increasingly we will see CPAs be not so much about after-the-fact confirmation and auditing of routine business transactions, but about as companies evolve to blockchain-based business processes and models, the CPA's responsibilities will be to advise them on the design and implementation of those systems and processes and provide advisory services after the fact, not only about general financial management as they do now, and certainly will still need to do in the future, but also about how they can leverage blockchain and related technologies to take full advantage of the changes that will be taking place.
Now, it's interesting with blockchain, it's moving up consulting services as being the predominant service being provided. It's usually the orphan child after audit and tax. You have consulting services, but now it seems that consulting services is coming to the forefront, which leads me to my next question of what might blockchain mean for auditing services?
Well, and that's a very good question. So let's take a little bit closer look at that. In the case of auditing services, Bear with me a second. Let me move on to the next slide for you. Okay, so again, in the near term, even as companies begin to move to blockchain, traditional auditing services are still going to be required for the many business transactions that are not yet verifiable via blockchain. So that's going to continue. But at the same time, CPAs are going to have to start to understand how to deliver services to assist their clients in automatically verifying those transactions that can be verified via blockchain. As we look out 5 to 10 years, large companies and increasingly mid-sized companies and a few small companies will be doing most of their, if not all of their, routine business transactions via blockchain. And what that means is that those traditional audit processes can be automated. And that changes the role. So auditors are still going to have to, you know, continue to provide those assurance services. But again, looking out longer term, we're increasingly going to see them adding value in such things as how do you structure the systems to provide you with the internal controls, especially leading up to the engagement in transactions that are then conducted and reflected via blockchain, if not directly conducted through blockchain, and the coding of smart contracts to run on the blockchain to make sure that the smart contracts are coded in such a way that they actually do meet both the agreed business objectives of the parties involved in the smart contract and also are in accordance with appropriate internal financial and accounting controls. So this means continued education is going to be very important for CPAs to understand the impact of blockchain on their audit practices as well as its effects on their clients. Longer term, what we're going to see is the ability for auditors to, and in many cases simply remotely, and in a semi-automated way, monitor real-time data feeds from their clients and immediately be able to advise their clients if a red flag comes up and indicates, here's a problem, here's a transaction that appears that it might not be in compliance with appropriate accounting standards, or conversely, it may be perfectly well in compliance with accounting requirements, but it may be something that, to the CPA's knowledge, is not in accordance with general business practices of this particular client, and there's a high value that could be added by CPAs and looking at these types of things. So the judgment factor, the understanding of the client's business and the application of judgment is going to be a very, very important part of business moving forward.
Let me ask you the same question as I did about auditing services. What is blockchain's impact going to be in the tax services area?
All right. That's an excellent point. And again, let me take it in the near term. Entities and individuals will still self-report the way that they do today. But longer term, we're going to begin to see return-free filing and ultimately even collection of taxes. We already see this with value-added taxes in countries like Estonia and several other countries around the world, mostly smaller countries, but it's already beginning to take place. And what this means, the best analogy I can use today are the sales taxes that are routinely collected from consumers and businesses that are purchasing items at the time of the transaction. You know, we don't submit a sales tax filing report at the end of the month or quarter or year. Those taxes are collected on the fly. Now, they are typically not forwarded to the governmental agencies and along with reporting by the retailers who are collecting those taxes in real time. But certainly blockchain will enable the technology to do that. And furthermore, other kinds of taxes that are relevant and appropriate to various types of business transactions will begin to be collected, recorded and collected on a real-time basis moving forward in the future. The IRS is already looking at what the implications of this are for both income and other kinds of governmental taxes. And increasingly, state and local governments are looking at how they might be able to leverage the reliability of blockchain-based accounting systems to collect both information on and actual payment of various types of taxes in real time. Now, what this means is that, especially in the longer term, over the next 5 to 10 years, CPAs who have a tax practice will have to think of themselves as moving from simply providing the service of preparing tax returns on behalf of their clients to really becoming blockchain-enabled tax specialists. In other words, people who can advise their clients on how properly to do that. And there's going to be issues that come into play. For example, for a lot of taxes, organizations may have options in various ways as to how those taxes are submitted. And even if the taxes are recorded and collected in real time, CPAs may have a valuable role to play in aiding their clients and making sure that the way in which they're reported and collected and the amounts that are collected as a result are those that are in compliance, of course, with all the appropriate laws and regulations, but also most advantageous to the entity that's doing the tax reporting and allowing it. So making sure systems are set up ahead of time to do that. And if for some reason something slips through and they're not reported and collected appropriately, aiding them perhaps in addressing any over collection that may have taken place as a result of that after the fact and correcting the design of those systems and processes so that they're done correctly moving forward.
Back to consulting services, what are the implications, particularly for those consultants who are serving industries that are data-driven? Because CPAs are historically looking at historic data, particularly in the audit area. So how will they have to approach data, that is more prospective in nature?
Yeah, that's an excellent question, Steve. So I would say look at it like this. Yes, you're correct. I don't see the fundamental function of CPAs going away from or no longer including ensuring that systems and processes are designed, implemented, and executed, and confirming after the fact, albeit with increasingly automated tools, that they have been executed so that the historical data right up to real time is accurate and has not been changed in any way that is in violation of general accounting principles, various different legal regulations, and so forth. But increasingly, because so much of that will be automated, the value that they will be able to add is to also assist these clients in making sure that their systems and processes are able to be forward-looking and are looking at decision processes that can statistically project forward data where it's valid to do so and make decisions based on, here's what appears to be likely to be happening in the near future. And even to some extent, as you begin to move into integrating AI with blockchain and traditional accounting and business management systems, automating certain decisions in terms of how do we want to. In other words, if the projection of what's likely to happen is not the most desirable outcome, well, what do we need to do differently? And how can we advise, how can we have systems that can, in an automated way, advise business decision makers as to what the best course of action might be? And in some cases, perhaps even automate that course of action if authorized to do so by those decision makers on an ongoing basis so that companies can respond as quickly and effectively as possible to changing market conditions. In this kind of a scenario, of course, blockchain is a critical and necessary component, but just one piece of a much bigger system of sophisticated systems that CPAs are, like it or not, going to have to know a lot more about than just the accounting entries, but also how these systems and tools can be used to aid their clients in achieving optimal long-term strategic objectives.
So in other words, it's almost as if the responsibility for understanding industry market changes, CPAs will have to consider the different sorts of inputs into the systems to come up with a desired result at the end. Is that what you're
yeah, saying? I think that's exactly true. And the inputs are no longer going to be just internal accounting entries. But as increasingly their clients are implementing systems that are forward-looking and that incorporate AI-enabled decision-making capabilities, decision management capabilities, where there are external sources of data. One of the great things about blockchain is, in many cases, these external sources of data, in turn, are blockchain-enabled so that they become highly reliable in terms of information that can be drawn in an automated way and used to help make sound business decisions moving forward.
So that leads me to my next question. What are who are the main participants in blockchain? For example, network operators, regulators, you know, groups of that sort.
Oh, that's a great question. And you know, there's a whole ecosystem of blockchain solution providers, blockchain-enabled participants. So let's look at a couple of different categories of that. First of all, there are all the various different direct trading partners of organizations. So in a supply chain, for example, you might have manufacturers, transportation carriers, logistics companies, third-party logistics companies, third-party warehousing organizations, distributors, retailers, and so forth. In the healthcare area, you could have healthcare providers, but also the individual doctors and practitioners. You could have insurance companies. You're going to have the patients themselves. And we could go on and on in industry after industry and identify various different. If you're in international trade, for example, you're going to have customs organizations and people who are collecting duties and authorizing whether certain types of products, for example, are allowed to be imported or exported. And that gets us to the broader area of government regulators. So if you're going to have national, in many countries, national governmental regulators that are involved in leveraging blockchain technology to see information so that they can do their regulatory job of making sure that all the participants, all the organizations that are involved in their area of regulatory authority are complying with the relevant laws and regulations. And then in federalist countries like the United States, for example, and you'll see the same thing taking place at a state and local governmental areas where regulatory authorities and taxing authorities, as I mentioned earlier, will be participants in the process. From a technical implementation standpoint, you're going to have technology solution providers. So, for instance, if you are involved in, say, a permission blockchain that's set up by a consortium that may involve many companies in your industry, it could be your industry trade association or a key industry trade association you're a member of, or perhaps you have an industry trade association that participates in a broader consortium for your industry or your industry and maybe a closely knit group of related industries. That consortium in turn may turn to external third parties to provide, say, the underlying blockchain platform. There may be different third parties that provide an overlay of encryption and security technology that will integrate with that platform. There will, of course, be the leading ERP or accounting software companies, particularly if there are companies that provide particular solutions for a given industry or, again, a closely related group of industries. And each of these technology solution providers, or I should say classes of technology solution providers, will have to be able to provide solutions that are blockchain enabled and where those blockchain enabled solutions have been customized and designed to meet the needs of a particular industry or industry vertical market or group of industries that are working together. So three major categories of categories, if you will, are all those various different trading partners directly in, or indirectly involved in the business transactions, all the governmental and regulatory agencies who have authority to review and participate directly or indirectly in those transactions through things like collection of taxes, for example, and all the different types of technology solution providers of various types will be involved. So it's a large, complex interacting set of ecosystems. And again, it's going to be important for companies ultimately to understand where they fit in that process. It's going to be important for their CPAs to understand how their clients are involved in these broader ecosystems, and to be in a position to advise those clients who are not yet fully integrated into all of these systems how best to do that to achieve their long-term financial and strategic goals.
So to put a ribbon on this, what does blockchain mean for CPAs going forward?
Well, you know, in the future, CPAs, as you can see from the slide here, the your traditional green eye-shaded accountant who is painstakingly cross-footing debits and credits is going to disappear. That's not going to be the role of CPAs. But there will always be jobs and important roles for human CPAs, no matter how much automated technology is adopted. It's going to be up to CPAs to understand this technology and the implications of this technology, which is why we wanted to put this program together today. And those CPAs who understand it, monitor it, and use it to help their clients improve analytical and cognitive systems and processes that can leverage blockchain-based information are the ones that will thrive by helping their customers thrive too.
Well,
so back to you to close up, Steve.
Well, thank you. A lot to absorb. Fascinating stuff. It's not the usual double entry bookkeeping. There's a lot to think about, a lot of participants in blockchain. There's security issues that no one ever even thought of 10 or 15 years ago. So to our audience who's viewing this webcast, and hopefully you had the opportunity to view last week's, if not, Jack and I strongly recommend that you do watch or get a broader perspective. There are two questions that we'd like you to ask of Jack Shaw, and you're more than welcome to email him at jack@jackshaw.io. And these questions, you could either ask one or both, but the first one is, what questions do you as a CPA have regarding blockchain? And the second one is, what questions are your clients asking regarding blockchain? So with that, we'd like to thank Jack for sharing his knowledge about this key technology and its impact on businesses in general and in the accounting profession in particular.
Well, you're welcome, Steve. It's been a pleasure.
I thought it was great, and I'm sure that our viewers will have a lot of takeaways from this. So I thank you for sharing your expertise, Jack.
Well, thank you. I appreciate it, Steve, and you have a great day.